Good morning. A poem analysis by Yogra Sachdevan. Monuments by Kamala Vijayaratnam. Outline, themes, techniques, language, and point of view. First, we will look at the themes of the poem. The poem unfolds the tragedy which results from an armed conflict in the country. While the poem, A Soldier's Wife Weeps, discloses how a wife of a departed soldier becomes a victim, this poem shows how his parents become preys for the war. Also, this poem reveals the psychological depression of parents due to the loss of their young children to war. Themes continue. The psychological depression of the parents can be compared with the condition of the people the poet observes in the people from the street in the poem, Morning at the Window, written by T.S. Eliot. The term aimless smile correlates with the terms faces are stern with unshed tears in this poem. Through this, the intensity of the sorrow is highlighted. The writer brings out the theme poverty in the poem. According to the speaker, the departed soldiers in the poem are from poor farmer families. As the farmers have lost their young children, they have to work hard with unbearable pains in their hearts to earn their living. Themes continue. The writer portrays a social class which has been categorized based on its labor contribution in Sinhalese community. Certain members in this class have become vulnerable for the horrors of the war in the country. Further, the writer emphasizes that many young men have died as far as a small geographical area is concerned. Through this, the writer allows the readers to imagine the conditions in the island as a whole. The speaker in the poem indicates how the parents are helpless as they lost their young sons to war. If they had lived, they would have helped their parents in their farming activities. But unfortunately, the sons died in the war, so that no one is there for the parents to help in their works. In addition, the customs followed by the Sinhalese on their New Year festival day have been brought into light. This too brings suffering and worries for the parents and readers as their loving sons are no more to celebrate this New Year festival together with their family members. Themes continue. This creates sympathy in the readers' minds as these parents have been compelled to live their entire life with these worries, as this loss cannot be replaced by any means in their life easily. Another pathetic condition in the poem is funeral rituals performed by the parents for their young sons, which is opposite to what happens in normal circumstances. Usually, sons perform these rituals for their parents once they die due to aging. That is a natural phenomenon in all societies. But what happens here is unnatural and unexpected for a father or mother when they give birth to their sons. This happens because of the war. Thus, the concept no one is winner in the war, all are losers, has been strongly emphasized. Another important theme in the poem is the suffering of the farmers who give food to the whole nation. Therefore, the poem indicates many layers of victims the war creates disappointedly. We will look at the techniques in the poem. The writer has used the technique capitalization in the poem, which highlights the pathetic condition of the parents who were forced to do all funeral rituals to their loving departed sons. Further, the term in memory of my son unfolds the love, care, worries, and the attachment of the parents towards their departed son in the battlefield. The title monuments suggest a war monument which have been erected either by their parents, siblings, or relatives in memory of their loved ones. The first stanza in the poem creates visual imagery in which the readers are able to imagine a bus journey of the speaker through typical Sri Lankan villages. The diction gold in the second stanza indicates the greater importance given to their departed ones. Techniques continue. It reveals how the siblings, parents, and relatives regard their lost and what they do to soothe their own hearts for a comfort. The diction's new name indicates the departed sons who come from different families. At the same time, the diction story's old highlights the incidents that happened in the past. Its consequences result beyond a greater time phase. Therefore, the everlasting effects of a war have been presented through these terms. Further, the poem unfolds how their particular village is affected as it has lost many young men to name. The diction hero indicates a soldier and the respect given to him as a departed soldier in Sri Lanka. The diction fell is also notable in the poem as it leaves the concept of rising soon after falling. This belief is in line with the ideology of patriotism. However, the diction here serves for honoring the departed soldier in a battlefield. The diction north symbolically indicates the northern province where armed forces fought. The term metaphorically represents the battlefield as well. The diction Bandara stands for a class of people in Sri Lanka who have traditionally engaged in farming. Through the terms such as hearth and new rice, the writer reminds the New Year customs of Sri Lankans, where they celebrate the festival joyfully with their family members. Further, as the speaker lists out what the young sons have missed in their life, the intensity of the tragedy has been increased. Technique continues. On the other hand, it facilitates the writer to take his message to the readers effectively. The diction's housewife and a farmer, which have been indicated by the writer in the poem, shows that the parents are innocent general public who earn their living through hard works under poverty. The term unshed tears reveals the unbearable worries of the parents. Further, the term a muddied loincloth helps to identify them as members of a working class in the country, which highlights the concept of poverty in the poem. As a whole, the poem reveals how a country misses its valuable men force who could have grown as gentlemen in many cases. Though the speaker speaks about the monuments built for the war heroes, remembering the life they have missed and learning lessons from the incidents have become greater and real tributes that is shown for such heroes in the poem. As such, the writer brings long-lasting sociological as well as psychological impact a war gives to its people in the country. Point of view, the poem has been written in first person and third person point of views. As far as the pains of the parents are concerned, it is looked from the point of view of an outsider, a traveler in a bus, which limits the exposure of true inner genuine feelings of the parents as the immediate victims of war. If these problems had been looked from the eyes of the parents, the intensity of the tragedy would have been more than we witness at present.